problems on this, and then we'll move on to another form. Evaluate. First one, can you discuss now? Can I write it like this? So this will correct. Now this I can write it as under root of 1 plus x by under root of Now, if you take this as your function, okay, you realize that the derivative of it, you can apply chain rule over here, under root of something is 1 by 2 under root of this, so it becomes root of 1 plus x times the quotient rule. X will get cancelled from here 2 and this 2 will get cancelled leaving with the 1. So this one will become you can spare a 1 minus x from here. So this and this will become root. This root and this root will combine. So you get 1 minus x by under root 1 minus x. So do you see we get this one? You can differentiate at your own end also with your own method also. So this is the function, then this is the derivative of the function. So your answer is going to be e to the power x under root of 1 plus x by 1 minus x plus c. This will become x by okay, now tell me this looks very close to the derivative of this, so let me just give a try. What's the derivative of this term?
1 minus x squared by x plus something.
what do you get?
196.
196.
You get this one, right? So put this up. And subtract this one. Okay. So at least this part is happy, right? Here again you have to apply little bit of brain. So this at least I'll seal it off. So now this part, what I'll do, I'll again take the LCM and all. Okay, if you take the LCM, what do you get? You get the same LCM, and in the numerator you have x square minus 2x plus 1, correct? I think I've seen this. I've seen this. Is this the problem I gave you little while ago? Did I give you x minus 1 whole square by x square plus 1 whole square? Check the first, second problem, third problem. Why do you feel I've seen this? This by this will give you 1 by x square plus 1 minus 2x by. Yeah, I remember I have done this one. Okay. Now can I say I can evaluate this also, I can evaluate this also. So my answer will be finally e to the power x, x by x square plus 1. That is the answer for this part. For that part, what is the answer? Okay. You may combine e to the power x. In school, they will never ask this. Third step. Undu, irudu, moru. Listen. See, the derivative of this term was this, right? So I just plugged in that term, but I subtracted it also. How did I subtract it? By just reversing the order in which I wrote. So that they will add up to give you 0. Okay. Next time. This form, this e to the power x f of x plus f dash x form needs a lot of practice. First do it from Adi Sharma, you have a complete exercise devoted to this concept. Solve as many as you can so that you are confident enough. This is your final answer.
That
type
is for both.
Sir, yeah, whatever I am going to discuss is applicable for both of them.
Sir, in this question, can we add the subtract x plus 4 to get the denominator and the numerator plus
4? See, any action that you do should lead you to a form or type that we have discussed so far. If it is helpful, why not? We can do it. Can I raise it now? on in a similar fashion. So let's say I call this integral as I. Okay. Let us apply by parts. Now these are the last two of the I net. Right? You can take any one of them as U and V. Doesn't make a difference. Both are easy. Correct? And both are recursive also. Which one you want to take as U, which one you want to take as
V? V as well as R.
Okay. Okay. U or V?
U.
So I is equal to U times integration of sin bx. What is the integration of sin bx? Integration is minus cos bx.
Minus cos bx.
Plus ultimately that will become plus. Is that okay?
So that is there.
This term is actually your other one. Anyways, we'll come to it. First, let us take out the A by B term. Can I write it like this? Yes or no? Now, can I apply again IVP on this part?
Oh, you may come to my
U. V. What is the integration of cos bx? Minus become minus e to the power ax cos bx by b. If you open the brackets, you will get a by b square e to the power ax sin bx minus a square b square integration of e to the power ax sin bx. Can I say this term is I again? So ultimately you are writing I is minus e to the power ax cos bx by b plus, do one thing, make it as b square so that we can take them together. Bring this term to the left side. And I am combining these two terms by taking the LCM b square. E to the power ax I can take common. B square gone. Bring the A square plus B square down. This becomes your answer. If you don't identify that I over here, it will go in an infinite loop. Okay, can you get me the answer for this one? If you are sharp enough, you know the value of I. This is required. So from the second step itself, you can get the answer. No need to redo the entire thing once again. But still, tell me the answer. What do we get? B cos B cos bx or B sin bx?
B sin bx.
Plus A cos bx. Yeah, please write it down, everybody. Nothing clear. First one is clear. Second one, either you derive from the beginning or use the second step. What is the second one? E to the power ax times a cos bx plus b sin bx by a square plus b. Can I clear this part? So to get the second one, I will use the same step. So I know the result, e to the power ax, a sin x minus b cos bx by a square plus b square. This you take on the other side, it becomes e to the power ax cos bx by b. So better write it as b square, if that helps. This will be equal to a by bi. Yeah. So you can do one thing, you can do a e to the power ax sin x by a square plus b square. And this part you can write it as e to the power ax cos bx 1 by b minus b by a square plus b square. This is the equation. So this becomes a square by b a square plus b square. Okay. Drop the factor of a. Multiply with b. So check, is the answer e to the power ax a cos bx plus b sin bx by a square plus b square. Is this what you mean? So this is the answer for the second integral. Now the question comes, do I have to remember this?
Yes.
If you do, you save your time.
Hey, how do you remember it, sir? Every day keep on chanting.
Don't chant, practice. Problem. For the next 1.5 months, just like you practice trigonometry, you should be practicing integration. First one is?
x by 2
sin of log x minus cos of log x.
Yes sir.
For your any reference, I'll write down the formula that we discussed. Because